are new here, my name's Elizabeth. I'm a medical student and an artist. Today we are getting all close and personal because I am going to show you the inside of my London studio. Now, I just want to say that objectively, the space is the size of a medium small shoebox, but considering the city and considering my expectations and previous places of residence especially, it does feel like a mansion. So bearing all those in mind, let's get started. So as soon as you enter, there is the coat hanger where I keep my painting. Next to it is my easel, and this poor thing doesn't get a lot of love recently, but come summer, hopefully I will be able to finish this painting. Over here we have what I can only assume was supposed to be an eating table because it has a stool next to it. But I tried it once when I first moved into this flat. I felt as though I was a child and being punished for something to stand near a wall by my teacher. It's just a very awkward setup. So currently I just use it for my paints, my paint brushes, and my keys. Underneath it is my infamous kettlebell. Since gyms have been closed in lockdown, my muscle loss trajectory has closely followed that of my YouTube growth, shocking and exponential. So this little thing down here is the only ray of hope that I have until things start loosening up again. Now we have the fun part, the main space. I have become intentionally and unintentionally a bit of a minimalist. So my flat is quite empty. The only things that I carry with me everywhere are my paintings and my books, and nothing else really matters to me that much. So if we first get the boring bit out of the way, this is my kitchen, nothing special about it. There is just this fake plant, which I wish was real, and my second mini easel on which I prop up some sheet music. So when I'm cooking, I try to practice reading music so I don't forget how to. Now my favorite part of my room is my desk. These books behind me have gotten so much attention and there's a lot of questions on them. This little wall over here is composed mainly of books that I read in my gap year, from medical law to anatomy to neurology to kind of medical ethics, and a lot of things that I was very, very interested in at the time and still am. There's a healthy mix of books on astrophysics here too, which is one of my biggest passions. Philosophy is one of my favorite ways to unwind and spoil myself. So if I am feeling particularly indulgent in taking time off, that is what I will do. On the other side, we have some extra books, which you will notice are flipped the other way around. The reason for that is that these are my preclinical medicine books and I do not have any particular fondness for these topics. So I just try to forget that I ever spent ages trying to learn them. Next, we have my computer, which there's really nothing special about it. I prefer my laptop, honestly, but it's a huge screen. So sometimes if I want to have Notion and Anki and my lecture and Google, for example, open, it works a bit better. Next, we have my skull, and this also gets a lot of attention. It unfortunately is not real. I used to have a real one in my first year of medical school, but I had to return that to the university and I felt very lonely. So I bought another fake one, I think, to replace it. Apart from being my roommate with a better bone structure, this skull over here is also my symbol of memento mori, which is basically the idea that we can benefit from remembering that we will soon die, so we can appreciate the present a bit more. Next, we have my stethoscope, which I hang next to my computer. This is pretty cringe, but also who am I trying to impress because it looks nice? So that's fine, I leave it there. Here we have the weeks of my life calendar. I color in every week as it passes, and it makes me feel as though every chunk of a week is more significant in some sort of way, and I try to make the most out of every single one. I think it also kind of has the effect of slowing time down and making you live more in the moment. Seeing as though we almost have a historical moment every 8 minutes in 2021, I don't know that I really need this, but yeah, I still love it. Next, we have my bed. There's really nothing special about it apart from my huge appreciation for having a double bed. You probably have one corner which is never, never empty, and that is definitely the case for me. I have a video where I talk about productive procrastination, and I always leave a bunch of books or things that I want to do in that corner of my bed, and hopefully I will get to them. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't. Here, my surgery book has never been opened, but I did read and reread Show Your Work by Austin Kleon. And also I have some medical flashcards, which if I'm feeling particularly in the mood, I will also try to do. Ironically, for someone who only wears that, I really, really love white bed sheets and white towels. So all of these are only pure white in my house. I just feel that one of the biggest small pleasures in my life is getting out of a shower into fresh, crisp, white, clean bed sheets. I don't know, it makes me so, so happy. So I try to maximize those little pleasures as much as possible. So above my bed, I have the rest of my paintings. All of these were made during my gap years, except this one down here, which was made during my first year of university. They all have a very significant message to me, and they're very, very important. So I go through the pain of very carefully carrying them with me whenever I travel or move, and they are definitely worth it. Next, you have my window, which, including me, is the thing that gets the most attention in this flat, and she absolutely deserves it. The view from here, especially at night, is absolutely breathtaking. I remember when I was young, I used to dream of the days when I would get a city view like this, and I appreciate it every single night. It also serves as my second desk, where I will take this little stool here and sit in front of it to do some work on my computer at night, or I will take my tea and sit near the window and kind of look at the city for inexcusably long amounts of time. Next, you have my closet, which is fairly small, and yes, everything inside it is completely black, except for a jean jacket, which I will sometimes wear during the summer, but it is something that I am considering changing, so I'll keep you up to date with how that goes. Next, we have my bathroom, which is fairly standard. My favorite area is this over here, where I get ready and unready in the evenings and morning. My minimalism extends to my makeup collection, wherein I only have one thing of each, and I'll only replace them once they're over. Now, I feel as though there's a lot more I could say about my books, the meanings behind my paintings, and my desk setup. So although no one has specifically asked for these videos, I will just probably put them together anyway. And if you're interested, you can watch them. I hope you enjoyed this video, and I genuinely apologize that I could not film it better on my own. As always, if you made it so far, thank you so much for spending this time with me. I hope you have a wonderful rest of your day. Be kind to yourself and others, and don't believe everything you think. Thanks. Bye.